Well, they're trying to take everybody's three people together. I don't think this is what they were thinking about. So I'm going to turn things over now in a couple of minutes, but before we do, and Mark's going to do a rendition of the old first and last verse. But before we do, they're going to say, they say cut back, we say fight back, all right? They say cut back.
We say fight back.
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 Make some noise, everybody.
Windswept land, we love. has loved our father, so we love.
Where once they stood, we stand.
Their prayers we raise to heaven above. God guard thee, Newfoundland. God guard thee, God guard thee, God guard thee, Newfoundland.
Recognize the tremendous value that workers in Alberta contribute to this entire country,
and how this makes a more fair and equal society for all of us from coast to coast to coast. We are so grateful as well for your leadership in ensuring that this continues to happen despite all adversities. Please know that not only the Newfoundland Labrador Federation of Labor, but the people of our province want you to know that we have your back.
Woo! 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 Woo!
Tell you, we don't want it. conversations you held across the province. You bragged about being an open and transparent government.
Boo!
One thing I'd like to know, who consulted with you about the levy idea? Who consulted with you that it was a good idea to tax lower and middle income earners?
Boo!
They hurt workers and their families, they hurt communities, they hurt the economy, and with unemployment at 14% already, we don't need more people out of work. Cutsville hurts local businesses and regional economies, and the people getting laid off by this government will no longer be spending money in local stores and restaurants. This budget is especially bad for our rural communities, the very communities that are the backbone of Newfoundland and Labrador.
Woo! Woo! Woo!
Premier Bob, you better check your briefing notes again, because your job was to ensure that the people in Newfoundland and Labrador can access quality public services. Your job is to build a strong economy with good jobs that keep us here. Your job is to create real plans about how our province can grow, how we sustain our economy, how we protect our environment. Premier Ball, where is the vision? Telling you, get off your high horse and do the right thing.
Yeah!
understand that times are tough. We also understand that taxes are the price that we pay to live and enjoy a civilized democracy. We're here to stay, to say that those who benefit the most from all those past breaks, they now need to pay the most. It's time that this government embrace fair taxation, where each of us pay according to our ability to pay.
Yeah! Woo!
Labradorian today.
Woo!
The In the past couple of weeks, I've had the privilege of traveling our province. And I say it's our province, not the province of the federal government. I've talked to people across every community that I've been in. I've went into their workplaces. I've stopped and talked to them in their coffee shops. I've stopped and talked to them in their supermarkets and their corner stores. And their stories are the same. One thing has become crystal clear. This is not a union issue.
No.
But it's an issue that has unified each and every one of us. We're all in this together collectively.
Yeah.
Our communities, our seniors, our youth, our most vulnerable, and the women who are disproportionately affected by the cuts in this budget like no other demographic. This budget has irked every Newfoundlander and Labradorian from Maine to Harbor Britain to St. John's to Port of Bass. To Harbor Grace, it is unbelievable what they have done to working women and men, what they have done to our youth, what they have done to women. It's unforgivable. Let me tell you about a couple of people that I met. And I said I have but a few minutes. But the Premier and Minister Bennett and the Liberal MHAs have not had the guts to go look people in the eye. Let me tell you about a woman in Arbor Brighton. And she just copied me again last night on a letter that she's sent to Minister Haggie. A woman that is fighting for her life. A woman that is now in the need of dialysis. And less than 2 years ago, they put a dialysis unit in her community to service the Conagra Peninsula. Less than 2 years ago, and we collectively contributed with our tax dollars to put it there. And guess what this Liberal government is doing? They're closing it on this woman. This woman's extended family lives in Arbor Britain, a large family. When she's fighting for her life, she needs her family. She needs her community. She needs her family home to live in. She's been told to sell it. Move to St. John's and wait for everybody. The following day, myself and some of the leaders from NAPE, we crossed the bay and went into Grand Bank. And again, I was approached by a woman, a proud mother. She was proud because her young daughter had moved back to Grand Bank. She had brought her young family back there. They were going to set, our young people are leaving communities, but in this case, her daughter had moved back home. She brought her children and her spouse. She bought a home. She has a long-term mortgage. Guess what? Premier Bow, Kathy Bennett, you have destroyed her future. You took away her job, and now she not only has to leave Grand Bank, she likely has to leave Newfoundland and Labrador. Some of the services that our rural communities depend on. I've been into Gambo last Saturday morning, arrived here around 10 o'clock in the morning, expecting to see 20, 30 people. A rally that Labour had not organized, the community there. When myself showed up, there was over 250 concerned citizens. My friends, they made promises to get elected. They raised hope to get elected. And then in the stroke of a pen, just 2 weeks ago, they introduced a document, a mean-spirited budget that destroyed the hope, that destroyed the future that took away those promises to young women, to young men, to seniors, and they shattered the future of Newfoundland and Labrador in a single stroke of a pen. Let me tell you, let me promise you, for those who can fight, we will stand with you. Myself, the leadership of NAPE, our board and executive and our members will stand with you and fight this government. To those of you who are unable, to those of you that cannot have your voice heard, we will be your voice. And I'm proud to be part of my union, the labor movement and the labor leaders that stand there with me today, the women's groups, the other groups that this government has brought together, will stand and fight with you to the last day of the year. I just ask you to be quiet for 1 minute. Very quiet. Very quiet. That's the support you're getting from your Liberal MHA. Absolute silence! In the communities across this province, they ran promising a stronger tomorrow. Like Sister Mary said a moment ago, if this is the stronger tomorrow, no thank you. My dear friends, thank you for turning out every day and sending a strong message. One thing I assure you on behalf of an organization I'm proud to be a part of again. I've said this in rural communities of Harbor Breton and Wabash and Harbor Grace. I am prepared. We are prepared.
Yes, we are!
Are you prepared?
It will widen the wage gap for women.
lock women and their families into poverty, forcing them to be more reliant on services that are now gone. Let's be clear here, the pain is not spread evenly, and the pain, there is more to come. Other choices could have been made, and other choices must be made. Absolutely no one who advocates for these types of broad cuts and regressive taxes, which disproportionately and negatively affect women, can ever claim to be an advocate for equal rights for men and women, or an economy that works for everyone. We want a fair deal for women. Why do we want a fair deal for women? Because ignoring half of the workforce in this province means realizing only half of the economic potential of this province. We want a better deal because women will experience less violence and living conditions. They experience better mental health, less addiction, and better physical health outcomes. We want a fair deal for women because it will help close the wage gap, unburden women from poverty, and protect good-paying jobs with benefits. Why do we want a better deal for women? Because the economic status of women has a direct impact on our economy. If you raise women out of poverty, you raise their children and their communities out of poverty, and everyone benefits. Why do we want a fair deal for women? Because women have been serving lunch for a long, long time now.
After being promised, We have now got Education Minister Dale
Gray yeah!
that lotteries can somehow be given back to communities and run by anyone other than the employees who were hired to do so. Why do so to the hard who have dedicated their lives, making our public library system one to be proud of? The CUPE members of Local 2329 say such a move will take our province back more than 30 years. And for Kirby to suggest that libraries in schools will be open after and would not be staffed after school hours is an admission he doesn't understand what libraries are about. What an insult. What Kirby is really doing by laying off staff in 54 locations and suggesting someone other than library workers be doing their own jobs is union busting, brothers and sisters.
Woo!
Yes, if you didn't hear me, I said union busting at the worst time. And it's directly mostly at women in rural Newfoundland for now. I spoke to Kathy Bennett just yesterday, and I told her this was union busting, and CUPE would not stand for it. Shame on the Liberals! Kirby has gone from being a socialist, so he called himself a couple of years ago, to a union buster overnight. What an example to our children! That is the Minister of Education. Meanwhile, we also learned this week about a severed faculty who are former CEO of NLFL. A walking woman paid $4 million. The people in this world is already scratching their heads after learning of the extravagant use of taxpayers' money and the payout. Premier Ball says there's nothing he can do about it. His hands are tied. So we are paying already wealthy executive who walked out of his job, if you can believe Ball, more money than the entire saving from closing 54 libraries. This is obscene. Is there anybody out there? Anybody else out there thinks this is obscene? I also want to remind people that the provincial government has tried to remove our members' modest certain packages in the last two rounds of burning. Shame on them. I would like to tell you how upset I am with this government's decision to hire an outside law firm to handle mass burning with the private sector. The premier is such a privateer, he privatized his own job. Doesn't he realize that that's what he's supposed to do? Doesn't he realize that's what we pay him to do? The decision to retain McInnes and Cooper for legal and so-called crisis communication during the upcoming contract talks is simply more evidence that they have no knowledge, nor do we have any respect for the bargaining process. For over 40 years, CUPE and other unions have freely negotiated contracts with senior staff at Treasury Board. The final step has always been to sit down with the Premier of the province and settle all monetary items. So why the sudden change? You've got to ask yourself. This decision also flies in the face of government's attempt to reduce costs. Why on earth would they pay an outside firm $500 an hour when they have qualified staff who can do this work? Not only is this disrupting to their own staff, but we can only conclude that this is being done so that someone else can do the government's dirty work. They didn't even have the courage to look straight in the eye from across the bargaining table. They had retained the same hired guns that were involved in an 11-month labor dispute at St. John's Airport and an 18-month labor dispute at Delhi in Boise Bay. I have a message to the Premier of the Liberal government. If you think you're going to intimidate CUPE or any of the unions here around the hill with these measures, you're wrong. Especially by anti-union lawyers getting paid $500 an hour without our own union. Sisters and
throne.
The people are rising up against our government against their callous and arrogant way in which they stepped together with this budget. The people are rising up because they are afraid this Liberal government is going to have a yard sale on our cherished public services.
Woo!
There is good reason why Newfoundland has avoided pay increases in the past. That's because the evidence in other provinces has shown us that they are a terrible deal for the taxpayers. Do we want to be like Nova Scotia, where they spent $800 million for these 39 schools for 20 years?
No.
Does that sound like a good deal to you?
No.
20 years of these pink dreams and the people of Nova Scotia still don't even own those schools. All I can say is, you gotta be kidding me.
Yeah.
Brothers and sisters, ladies and gentlemen, let's rise up for our brothers.
Rise up! Rise up!
Against the two multi-millionaires who have made their main goal since getting elected in protecting their wealthy friends from paying their fair share of tax increases while asking the poor to pay an unjust and unfair share. Let's stand with the students here in Newfoundland, Labrador.
Good afternoon, sisters and brothers, Newfoundlanders and Labradorians. I'm Lana Payne, the Atlantic Regional Director with UNIFOR, Canada's largest private sector union. And Labrador Spring.
Yeah!
Today is about our collective anger towards a budget that unfairly, unjustly, and disproportionately impacts children, women, low and middle income working people. Promises were made a few short months ago. They were not only broken, but savaged in this budget. But we have, sisters and brothers, a bigger problem. The bigger problem is a complete lack of a plan to go forward.
Yeah.
A plan for good jobs, strong communities, and fair taxes. Closing half the province's libraries, taxing, a regressive deficit levy. These are not the makings of a progressive plan forward for our province. They won't produce prosperity or grow our economy. Indeed, the very opposite. This budget was devoid of hope at a time when hope and vision for the future of this place are so desperately needed.
Yeah.
Our government sent a cold and ruthless hacking away at the very fabric of our communities and the very things that speak to who we are as a people and as a society.
Yeah.
We need and expect leadership that brings us together during difficult times. Leadership that understands that we have tremendous, tremendous tools at our fingertips. Our people, our natural resources, and God damn it, our defiance.
Yeah!
Ingenuity, stubbornness, imagination, as Ed Rich wrote about this week, and a profound love of this place are powerful, powerful powerful weapons. And they must be harnessed. What we need is the political will and the know-how to tap into them, to be bold. We need solutions that build solidarity, that reinforce the collective spirit of this place, rather than decisions that pit worker against worker, community against community, and sector against sector. Sisters and brothers, nobody is denying that this occasion is piled high with difficulty. I'm not saying that the path forward is or will be easy, but we know that the same old slash and burn tactics give us the same old results. Our economy suffers, our communities suffer, and good people leave. Often amazing young people, the very future of this place. And it doesn't have to be this way. We need to use the solidarity you're feeling today and in the months ahead to demand a different way forward. We can turn our anger, which is really a reflection of our hope for Newfoundland and Labrador, into action. But we must do it together. Public sector workers are not the problem. But be prepared for teachers and nurses and librarians to be blamed. 54 libraries are not the problem. Affordable post-secondary education is not the problem. The problem, sisters and brothers, is a complete lack of a plan to harness our incredible strengths and build something great. Demand that. Demand something different, something better. If there's one thing that I've learned from the labor movement, it is that fighting back always, and I mean always, makes a difference. And that solidarity, my friends, can build something that stands the test of time for generations. Solidarity!
Solidarity! Go, go, go! Solidarity! Go, go, go!